are about to meet one extraordinary woman. She was born in a small African country. Her name is Fiori Giovanni, and she was meant to be in an arranged marriage at the age of 12. Then at 14, she was forced into the army, and at the age of 15, she fled her home country of Eritrea. In 2008, she settled in Australia and has not only become an incredibly successful businesswoman here, but she says she has proudly defied her destiny, and we have this extraordinary woman on our couch now. Fiori, welcome to Studio D. You are the most gorgeous woman, and you have quite the complicated and terrifying backstory. Take us back to the beginning and what life was like for you in Eritrea.
Yeah. I was born in a country where I felt first of all, for many people who doesn't know where Eritrea is, it's in the northeastern Africa.
Yeah.
Very, very small country.
Borders Ethiopia.
Borders of Ethiopia.
There's the map.
Lots of conflict there, isn't there?
Absolutely. And it's a very small country, like only 5 million, and in war for the last 20 years with Ethiopia, which is a much larger country, like 100 million people, population. Hence, I have to leave the country, but at the age of 15. But it's people are, despite of the atrocities, they're most generous and kind people. Culture very different from Australia, which is why I decided to write the book, because it traces my life story from escaping as a child bride, my life as a child soldier, and all the way my life in Australia, where I am a speaker and author.
There's so much to unpack here. Let's start.
Okay, well, let's start with, because when you were 12, your father told you you were going to marry this man you'd never met.
Yeah.
Who's a lot older than you. I think he was 25 or something. 25. How does that feel as a 12-year-old? I mean, you barely... You're a child.
You know, like, before I even tell you, like, my response to that, my sister, my older sister was a child bride. She had her first child when she was 13. Her second,
13.
Yeah, yeah. Her second child when she was 14. Her third when she was 16. And by the age of 33, she had 9 children and became a grandmother.
Wow.
And so...
So there was no future for you. No education. You were being asked to give all of that up, your independence.
Absolutely.
In order to become basically a vessel for children.
Obviously, here we would consider that child abuse. Did you feel like that's what it was? Did you feel like you were being sort of traded like a slave? Or is it something that was so much part of your culture that you thought, well, this is normal, my sister's done it and I'm going to do it, and you felt uncomfortable, but...
No, I didn't. It was the culture. Everybody accepted it. Everybody was happy to follow the path. But for me, like, I was questioning things. I feel like I didn't know any better, but I know this cannot be it. So I started questioning the status quo. I started questioning everything. Hence, I decided to leave by bicycling the neighboring country.
You bicycled your way out of
my
Eritrea.
Way to,
on
Sudan.
Your own?
Yep.
By yourself?
Well, I hired a guide to help me to cross the border.
Wow. As you do, of course.
As you do.
So how old were you then? So as a 12-year-old, you said, I'm not going to marry this man.
Yeah, so I skipped being a child bride. After seeing my sister's torment, I basically put an ultimatum to my parents that if I was forced to marry, that I was going to take my own life. And so that worked. They cancelled my wedding, continued to school. At the age of 14, I learned, I became a child soldier. I became... we had a summer school training where it became a military training, and then where I learned how to fight, shoot, and kill in the military.
Wow.
And at 15, I felt like I had to break free, even if it meant dying in the process.
And this is in Eritrea, which it was so desperate that they're actually training children. We've heard about child soldiers in other parts of Africa, training children to fight in the war against Ethiopia.
Yeah, because of the child, you know, the population difference I just mentioned to you guys. So while in Ethiopia, only young men go, in Eritrea, like, you know, younger, older, and everyone.
How did you get to Australia then? How did you get here?
Well, I first went to Sudan by bicycle, lived there for a year, and then I crossed to Libya through the Libya desert, then by boat to Italy, then to Belgium. I sought asylum. I built a career in office management, and 7 years later, my younger brother attempted the same process journey that I did from Libya to Italy.
What? And but all those countries are war zones. I mean, South Sudan is a war zone as well.
But it's like you just take one step at
and
a time.
You just
take, yeah.
You keep ahead of the...
And had you heard fighting. About Australia? Had people spoken of Australia in glowing
not.
Terms?
Actually,
why Australia?
In 2007, my younger brother, like I said, attempted the same process journey from Libya to Italy, and his boat went missing, and we still haven't heard 12 years from him.
Wow.
I was in extreme grief, and I kind of decided to start traveling to just shake myself free of the grief, so to speak.
So your brother's probably
dead. It's Australia is how...
The conditions and the danger in getting here. And then, so how did you get here and where did you stay when you arrived?
I first came here for a holiday, just for 11 days. To my surprise, I met a guy, and the same year he followed me to Belgium. We got married in Belgium. In the next year, I came here to Australia, which, despite of my near misses with death, it turns out that I was actually going to die here, be murdered by my husband, because he turned out to be a physically abusive guy.
Wow.
You got to Australia and you found love. And we have to show your beautiful family.
Yes.
Can we bring him in?
Yes,
this is Ben
amazing,
and
man.
Baby Otis.
Oh,
my gosh.
Hello,
look at him.
Sorry.
Hey guys,
what a
how
beautiful
you
story.
Different husband.
Different, this is not the murderous killer.
Now, Fiori is the author of several e-learning books, and her autobiography is titled Defy Your Destiny. It's available from her website, FioriGiovanni.com. Fiori, you are an extraordinary woman. We're so happy to call you Australian. And thank you as well for bringing in your gorgeous family.
Could be a movie.
Oh,